INTPs are critical thinkers that prefer analytics, research, and intellectual pursuits. Intelligence is really the foundation of their values. Now, this intellectual side also means that they tend to be a little more skeptical, and especially when that comes to weight loss. They're going to look at all the varying sides of each weight loss theory before they jump in. They also like to be different and try new things. Of course, the INTP is most critical of themselves more than anyone else because they have a desire to be masterful and perfect in all things. INTPs prefer to look at getting healthy as a means of being more alert and able to learn. They use their health as a means to learn and to avoid anything that's going to make them feel sluggish, which is really going to hinder their intellectual abilities and their desire to be intellectually challenged. The INTP also likes to discuss and debate. They believe that knowledge is power and will enjoy the opportunity to apply this ability to their journey of being more healthy. INTPs need comprehension and information to realize and maintain their weight loss and their fitness goals. The INTP will not like a weight loss program that is going to have rigid plans, regimens, and deliverables. They're not going to like anything that will require them to be stuck in a systematic approach. They also will not like anything that's going to be very social or require a social aspect. Your best diet plan is going to be something that is proven to work but still gives you flexibility. You also need a plan that you can do individually and not have to attend a group meeting or rely on others. The keto diet is a great option for you. Another good option is the Mediterranean diet. There are great apps for your phone that will help you to learn and navigate through the information of these options. Since you do like to do your own research, why don't you do an internet search for diets that are similar to the keto and Mediterranean? You can then create a plan that is based on your research that works best for you. Here's a couple of other tips for you. Make sure that you track the foods that are really making you feel less alert and which foods really energize you. This is going to help you to focus on what matters most to you, which means your intellectual, right? Keep healthy foods on hand, and since you don't want to be confined too much, really making sure that you keep healthy things to grab is going to be easier for you and help you to stay on your track to reach your goals. The INTP is more cerebral and intellectual than physical, so any exercise that is like work is going to be very unappealing to them. So try something that is easy on the brain and on your bones, like swimming, walking, or even elliptical. And since you like to be cerebral, remember to choose something that you might be able to learn while you're doing your exercise, like listening to a book while walking, or watching a documentary, listening to a podcast while on a stationary bike. Also, remember to stir things up, change it up. Don't commit to just one routine because remember, you like things that are different, variable, and spontaneous. So here are some quick do's and don'ts for the INTP. Make sure you do research and use your analysis. From there, then, you create your own individualized approach. Remember, you do become your best expert on yourself. You do enjoy competition, but only with yourself. That's going to work best with you. Set some goals. Make sure that they're long-term and short-term. Study and research all the different theories, and be sure to also look at experts. What do they suggest? Then compile all those results and see what comes up and how you can use pieces of all these things to create a plan that works best for you. So things to avoid. Anything that's in person or group meetings, you're not going to enjoy that. You don't like an expert doing telling you what to do all the time. That's actually going to make you more skeptical and push you away. Emotions. Oh yes, no, you prefer data and research over emotions. So anything that's going to be a little touchy-feely and getting to the source of why you overeat, what feelings you have, is going to bother you more than anything. And then following others, you really prefer to be your own trailblazer. One last word of advice. Since you enjoy research and analyzing information, you may want to find an expert, someone that you really appreciate. And it doesn't have to be a plan. Maybe it's just someone on Instagram or YouTube where you can get a daily dose of good information. So good luck.